us right off them tonight.
So everybody's always doing the puns with, you know, John's bringing the party. Do you ever feel like it's pressure to live up to the party thing? And like some days you're just like, no, I'm bringing the hangover today.
No, we're pretty much well known that we do live up to the name.
At all times. There's no time you get up in the morning
my
and you're like,
my guitar player that it does a lot of my studio work that plays on the record, Rob, he's like, we're sitting in lunch. He goes, I heard that you and your band are the rowdiest people on the road. But not like crazy rowdy, but just fun, but still rowdy. And I was like, well, we have a good time.
Because you just had to live up to the name, I guess. All right, fully living up to the name.
Do you still have a topless photo of Tim McGraw on your bus?
Yeah, shirtless.
Yep.
Shirtless.
Topless, shirtless.
It sounds more inappropriate when you say topless.
I know, I like it.
Does it work for motivation?
It does. I mean, he's, what is he? I don't know how old Tim is, but he's in his 50s and he looks great. And,
yeah, he is caught.
So it's, but he does work out like 6 hours a day.
Yeah.
I always remember that movie with The Rock and Kevin Hart, and he played this character, Dwayne Johnson I'm talking about. He's a big fit guy. And he's like, yeah, just to look like this, you just got to work out in the gym 4 hours a day. Yeah. But Tim's pretty close to that. But we got to work out with Tim, and he has this like awesome gym that like has pop outs on each side. And it's like
really?
A real gym, and it's got treadmills and mirrors and a whole speaker system. And he's got his trainer. And so I kind of made this. I had a bus trailer that hauls my motorcycles, and I got little clips for like TRXs and some dumbbells that, you know, just little stuff. So I kind of, why I took the Tim thing was because he had a gym trailer and I got a gym trailer, but mine's really small compared to his.
Well, you're getting there.
You gotta work toward it.
So, yeah, but it's fun.
Thinking back on all the people, including Tim, that you've opened for, who, if you had to be deserted on a, you know, an island and you can only take one of them, who would you take with them for best survival? Take with you.
Oh, definitely Luke.
Luke, why is that? Because he can hunt?
We're both hunters and he's got a plane.
So the plane would get you right back off the deserted island again.
He owns the plane. So, yeah.
Eventually that plane he owns would find him. All right.
Since your mom set you up with your girlfriend that you have now, how did you feel about that when your mom's like, hey, I know this hairdresser, I'm going to fly her out so you guys meet? Were you like, oh, come on, mom? Or were you kind of open to it?
Well, there's, you know, these days, there's pictures.
I wasn't lying.
I was kind of on the fence about it first, personally. I was like, I don't know if I want a relationship right now.
Touring and whatnot, all the time.
And then I met her and we had fun, and she's been great, so.
All right.
Blind date.
From your mom.
Semi-blind date.
All right, and final question. The song Heartache on the Dance Floor, that sounds like that would be messy, a heartache on the dance floor. But what really is the messiest thing you've ever seen on a dance floor in all your
definitely
time singing?
Throw up. For definitely throw up.
Not a bar fight?
Nah, throw up. Bar fights are, you know, bar fights or fights are, you know, if you do have security, like, they don't last long. But people who throw up, like, it's a big ordeal. Like, especially they, like, drank a lot. Like, you gotta push the crowd away.
You gotta shut the party down.
It goes everywhere. And, like, it just like, goes everywhere.
And the stench lingers for a little while.
And other people throw up.
Yep.
So it's like, you know.
I'm so glad that was my last question.
Yeah,
all right.
I'm proud of it.
All right. Thank you, Jon Pardi. We look forward to seeing you tonight.
Yeah.